Hey guys, how's it going? So, I decided to do a video tonight, a shaving video, obviously, where I'm going to do a shave, but I'm not going to talk about a specific product or a certain technique or anything like that. I just wanted to share my experiences as what I consider to be still a newbie. Anyway, before we begin, I'm going to use some Sharp Dressed Man by Sterling. This stuff smells really, really good. It smells kind of like a men's cologne in a way. Typical performance by Sterling. Good lather, or easily lathered and really slick. In my my Parker 24C open comb razor, using Astra SP blade on its second shave. And for a pre-shave, I've been using this by Paul Mitchell. I went and had a straight razor shave done by a barber recently, and they put this on first. It's Tea Tree Hair and Body Moisturizer, and it works really well as a pre-shave oil. I don't have an oil per se that I like to use, but this I really do like quite a bit. So I'm going to go ahead and put some of that on my face. And then I've been having my soap blooming, and I still like to use the bloom water to it just because I think it adds to this, like missing any addition to it can only help. So, what I wanted to talk about or go over kind of addresses, or not addresses, but it geared towards new wet shavers out there. And I guess what I'm going to call this is my shithead shaving moment. Yeah. And to those of you who are experienced, by the way, I've just been soaking my Omega. This is a boar hair brush, pure boar hair. It's probably my go-to brush. I love this thing. It's got a pretty good amount of backbone. Holds lather really well, but it gives it up when you start lathering on your face. Works really good, so I like it a lot. Anyway, so I've been wet shaving for about 2 years. And up until probably about a month ago, I knew it all. All you had to do was ask. It didn't matter. I figured, man, I've been doing this for 2 years. I know everything there is to know about it. Makes sense to me, right? Well, I suppose it's probably the same with anything. You do it long enough, you develop sort of complacency, maybe even cocky attitude. And that is kind of what happened with me in wet shaving at first. So, just gonna get the bowl lather here, get this going. So I watched a lot of videos and joined a lot of forums, and basically one thing I kept hearing was, if it works for you, do it. So I kind of took that to heart, and basically, I had one or two good shaves for something I was doing. I wasn't lucky, of course not, it had to have been my skill, right? And so the heck with anybody else. Any piece of advice? I didn't need it, because I knew what I was doing. Anyway, it's a little dry. I'm going to add some more to that. So, what I was doing when I first started wet shaving is I started shaving with this little baby right here. This is a Vanderhagen twist to open safety razor. Picked it up at Walmart for like 20 bucks. If Fisher-Price made a safety razor, this would be it. Sorry, Vanderhagen, but the razor sucks. Anyway, it was good at first because I had no idea what I was doing. And the first razor I got from, that's actually my second one, broke. It literally broke. I went to take the blade out of it on my third use, and the bottom stripped, and the whole mechanism wouldn't open. I couldn't get the blade out, so I had to throw the whole thing away. I literally had to go to the store and get another one because I didn't have another razor at the time. Anyway, so I shaved and shaved and shaved, and I, you know, kind of perfected my technique. Then I decided that I wasn't getting a good enough shave. Like, it wasn't getting close enough. So to me, it made sense that if I'm not getting close enough shave, that must mean that I need a sharper blade. And I was using the Vanderhagen safety razor blades that you also get at Walmart. So I did a review online, or read some reviews, and found some Astra SPs. And those, from what I understand, are considered not the sharpest on the market, but they're not dull by any stretch of the imagination. They're a good mid-grade blade. And they are. So I ordered a 100 pack of those. And I threw them in my Vanderhagen safety razor. Did a couple of shaves. Thought, it's okay. Better than it was, but it's okay. Still not baby skin smooth, which is what I wanted. So thought about it some more, and decided I needed a sharper blade. Why not, right? Couldn't be my technique. Couldn't be the fact that I was using a $20 razor, or that there are different razors out there, which I didn't bother to pay attention to any of the advice on the forums. Big mistake. So I bought a whole pack of feathers. Actually, I got a sample at first with just feathers. Made out of Japan, made in Japan, and arguably, the sharpest on the market. And again, put them in my Vanderhagen safety razor. So I got a pretty good shave. Better than prior. But it still wasn't baby skin smooth or baby butt smooth. But it was better than it was before. And in my own defense, I have a very tough beard. So the mistake I made then was, well, I've got the sharpest blades I can find. My technique is sound. What else can I be doing? Well, what else do I need? So I started looking into razors, and I found that there were other razors out there, different styles, different brands, that have different levels of aggression. And I just thought to myself, how could that be? The razor just holds the blade. The blade's either sharp or it's not. right? Wrong. I learned that different razors hold the blades at different pitches and expose different amounts of the blade out the side, depending on how much of that blade it exposes, negates the aggression of the particular razor. And I thought, oh, this is great. I already have the sharpest blade I can find. Let's get the most aggressive razor that I can afford. That's a great idea. Some of you experienced wet shavers who might be watching this are thinking, what a flippin' idiot. And you're right. What an idiot. And again, I was going on the one piece of advice that I did listen to, which was, if it works for you, do it. So I thought, if this works for me, I'm going to do it. I don't care what anybody says. So, I first ordered the Razor Rock Slant Bar, which from what I had read, slant bars were considered more aggressive than what you would call a quintessential standard safety razor. And it was, or it is. Now, I did achieve a baby butt smooth shave with it. It's great. Worked awesome. One little minor issue. That when I was done, my face felt like it was on the surface of the sun. Which I thought, that must be normal. That must be what you get when you get a smooth shave. And you couldn't tell me otherwise, because again, I knew it all. So, I said to myself, I actually went on Google and I typed in, what is the single most aggressive safety razor you can purchase? Mule R41, I think, topped out. And it was around the holidays, so I either couldn't find it, or I couldn't swing it, or something. And anyway, I ended up with the Parker. Actually, the Parker rated up there as well. The Open Comb 24C, which is what I'm using now. And I said to myself, yes! I'm going to get the best shave of my life. Oh, and top it all off, I decided to take on straight razor shaving at the same time, which I actually did listen to the advice that was given to me for that, and I'm doing pretty well with that. But I wanted to perfect the DE razor shaving as well. So, I waited and waited and waited. And my Parker 24C came in. I was so excited to shave with it, but I wanted to make sure I had a lot of growth because I wanted to just take it off, you know? So I waited a day. I took a fresh feather blade and loaded it in my Parker 24C. And I shaved with it. Off camera, of course. And I did. She managed to shave all the hair off my face. It was smooth like glass. But not only did I shave all the hair off, but I managed to take off most of my skin as well. Or at least that's how it felt. And I'm standing there looking in the mirror going, looks and feels great. Wow, it's on fire. It really hurts. Oh, I know what fixes that. Aftershave. So I threw on some aftershave. Which, those of you know, can help with razor burn. It can. But not like this. Remember the scene in Home Alone when he threw the stuff on his face and he screamed really, really loud? It's kind of like that, except for I think I was turning around in circles. It was like a combination of Home Alone and The Exorcist. Wasn't pretty. All because I didn't listen. So, recently, or actually I continued to do that because I just thought, that's the norm. And recently I was talking to my man, Douglas Smythe. And he said to me, you should try a pre-shave. I said, I am doing that. I've got a couple things I use. And he says, try a post-shave. I said, I have that. And then he said, you might want to switch to a, I don't want to say a less sharp razor, or a less sharp blade. And I said, you know, we were talking on text, and I said to myself, what the hell would I want to do that for? And it's not going to cut anything. And then he either said it or I had an epiphany. Or maybe something fell and hit me in the head. I don't remember now. But I said to myself, well, I have what's considered two of the more aggressive style razors in wet shaving. Maybe not the most aggressive brands, but the style anyway. And I've got the most, from what I know of, the most aggressive blade I can find in the market. I'm lucky I still have a face. So, and I said, by golly, he might have something there. And that guy's awesome. I really like Douglas Smythe. He's got a lot of good, now that I'm listening, he has a lot of good advice, and I love his videos. He's a great guy. But, so, he said, try Astra SPs. I said, it's funny you mentioned that. I have a whole pack of those collecting dust. Because I know everything. He said, try pairing the Astra with one of your razors. And try that. Then the second thing he said to me was, don't chase the BBS. Don't chase that smooth shave. It will come to you. And I said, huh, now that I had not heard before. I mean, I've heard not to be greedy, not to try to shave every single hair off. But I didn't listen to that because I knew everything. So, I said to him, all right, I'll give it a shot. So later on that night, I took a fresh fresh Astra blade, and I paired it into my Parker 24C, and I shaved. I went with the grain, I went cross grain one direction, cross grain the other direction, which I got that from Nick Shaves, thank you sir. And then I went against the grain. And then I did a cleanup pass to check for any small areas. But I didn't go crazy. I just took off what really felt like a lot of stubble to me. And when I was done, I took my Allen block, rubbed it all over my face. A little bit of stinging, but hardly any at all. I mean, there was very, very little, I think, underneath my neck area. And I thought, So I took a non-menthol, at least no non-menthol added, shaving, aftershave that I had. I think it was Sandpiper from Sterling. And I slapped it on my face. Zero pain. No burning, nothing. There was no me spinning around, needing a priest. There was no screaming at the top of my lungs, being home alone. It was just a really good shave. And I have to say, I've been shaving probably just over 2 years now. And it's so far, that shave was probably one of the best shaves I've had. Heeding those two pieces of advice really made a world of difference for me. And I think they would make a huge difference for anybody starting out. It's hard when you're doing this and you hear about all the people getting these awesome shaves and you want it too. You know, because you don't start doing this because you're having great shaves. So it's hard not to go for that. Not to go a little overzealous. It's hard not to do that. Because you're like, I got this kick-ass razor, I got this kick-ass blade, I got great products to shave with. Watched a couple videos, there we go. But you've got to stop, you've got to take your time, do the research, listen to what the people say. They're not talking for their health. These people all know what they're doing. They've been doing it a lot longer than you have. Now, you're going to make mistakes. There are pieces of advice, no matter what I tell you, no matter what anybody tells you, you're not going to listen, or you're going to want to try it anyway. What? Make sure I always have lather on the parts that I shave? I can clean that up real quick. It's just a blade. It's like a cartridge razor, right? Yeah, go ahead and try it without lather. See what happens. So, part of this video, a lot of parts to it, is to say thank you to Mr. Douglas Smythe for giving me that piece of information, or pieces of information. Oh, before I forget, not too much pressure. Yeah, I know they always tell you not to push, but once you start doing it, you realize you're not going to saw your face off, so you get, I can just dig right in. Don't do it. Just let the friggin' razor do the work. That's why these things are made out of brass and heavier metals, except for Mr. Fisher-Price here, which I think is aluminum, but it's no heavier than a Coke can. Don't get me wrong. Not a bad starter razor. Teaches you the motions. And it allows you to not cut yourself. Well, it allows you not peel your face like a potato. But you want to move on to something with a little more oomph later. In my opinion. Because you want to do what works for you. Anyway. So once I've learned that, or I should say once I decided to take his advice, and watched some of his videos, and I re-watched some others, things made more sense to me. So I suggest when you start shaving as a newbie, and if you're watching this video, you're probably a newbie. that you learn from other people's mistakes, like mine. And actually listen to other people. So that's going to be my word of advice to you, the newbie. Actually, words of advice. Listen to the pieces of advice that are out there, especially from the videos or the users on there that have been there a while and really have a good following and know what they're doing. Don't chase the baby butt smooth shave. Dougie's right. Let it come to you, because it will. Even if it doesn't right away, it will. And if you do decide to upgrade to a more aggressive razor, consider changing the blade. And when I say change the blade, I don't mean put it another one in there, more I mean change the brand. A different brand, because different brands have different properties, different sharpnesses. That's why they have so many blades, because everybody's skin is different. So experiment with them. Don't do what I did. Sharper is not always better. And so that's my advice. That's my recent experience for a shithead shaving moment of me not listening to others and taking others' advice. So, having said that, hope you have a good shave. Hope you enjoy your new wet shaving experience. To all the new people and those of you that are watching this for whatever reason who are already wet shaving, thanks for watching. I appreciate it. And if you can give me any further advice, I promise to take it into consideration. So, enjoy your day. Have a good shave, and we'll see you next time.